Hello, wonderful people. My name is Carol Vay and welcome back to my channel. Do you know that on May 9th, 1914, President Woodrow Wilson proclaimed the very first Mother's Day and said that we should thank our mothers and all mothers for everything that they do. But thousands of years ago, God gave us the same advice. In Exodus 20, verse 12, it says, "Honor your father and your mother, that your days may be long upon the land which the Lord your God is giving you." I know there are so many seasons we go through as moms, and even many people that don't celebrate on Mother's Day because they're grieving the loss of a child, grandchild, or mother. Now that I'm older myself, I can see all these stages that we go through. When we're little children, we believe that our mothers can do anything. When we grow a little older and enter into our early teens, we figure there's a few things that our mothers don't know. Later on in our teens, we figure our moms don't know anything. And in fact, we don't even really know what's going on in the real world, and nobody lives like we think we do anymore. By the time we reach our mid-20s, we realize maybe our mom does know a few things after all. And in our 30s, we start to wonder what mom might do in this situation. When you reach middle age, you wonder what mom would say about this situation. And by the time we're in our later years, we wish we had just one more chance to talk to our moms. I've been through all of these steps now and can totally relate to each step. But I can also totally relate to those who struggle with Mother's Day. On May 10th, 1987, was the first Mother's Day after I had lost my first baby, Spencer. I was at that age where a lot of my friends were having babies of their own and were celebrating that first Mother's Day with their babies in their arms. And even though I was pregnant with my next baby, Simon, I was still grieving the baby that I lost, which was still confusing to a lot of people who thought I should be happy that I was having another baby. So I really wanted to be considered a mother that first Mother's Day of mine, but my baby was in heaven and the next baby was still growing in my womb. I love how God's word gives us comfort when we're going through things like this. 2 Corinthians 1 verses 3 and 4 say, "Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort those who are in any trouble with the comfort with which we ourselves are comforted by God." Those early Mother's Days when I had little children of my own, I remember needing to still take care of my little ones and yet wanting to celebrate Mother's Day with not only my mother, but my mother-in-law, and always needing to work out holidays to split time between the families and barely have any time to really enjoy the holiday to ourselves. Today, I actually wanted to talk about the Proverbs 31 woman. And some people might look at this woman like, how could I ever live up to that standard and that example? And especially since the book of Proverbs was written by Solomon, who had 700 wives and 300 concubines. But the interesting thing at the very beginning of Proverbs 31 is it says, "The words of King Lemuel, the utterance which his mother taught him." I'm not sure whether teachers are sure whether Lemuel is a pet name for King Solomon himself, or whether Lemuel is somebody else who told this story to Solomon. Let me know in the comments if you know the answer to that. The interesting thing about this Proverbs 31 woman is that this list of what she accomplishes wasn't meant to give us like a one-day picture of her life, but a whole lifetime picture. And the older I get, I can see where now that our kids are grown up, it's almost like you are out in the marketplace investing in your future and planning and almost being like She was a business owner, but while her kids were still little, she was busy taking care of her family and even sewing their clothes. So starting in verse 10, it says, "Who can find a virtuous wife? For her worth is far above rubies. The heart of her husband safely trusts her, so that he will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not evil all the days of her life. She seeks wool and flax and willingly works with her hands. She is like the merchant ships. She brings her food from afar. She also rises while it is yet night and provides food for her household and a portion for her maidservants. She considers a field and buys it. From her profits, she plants a vineyard. She girds herself with strength and strengthens her arms. She perceives that her merchandise is good and her lamp does not go out by night. She stretches out her hands to the distaff and her hand holds the spindle. She extends her hand to the poor. Yes, she reaches out her hands to the needy. She is not afraid of snow for her household, for all her household is clothed with scarlet. She makes tapestry for herself. Her clothing is fine linen and purple. Her husband is known in the gates. When he sits among the elders of the land, she makes linen garments and sells them and supplies sashes for the merchants. Strength and honor are her clothing. She shall rejoice in time to come. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and on her tongue is the law of kindness. She watches over the ways of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praises her. Many daughters have done well, but you excel them all. Charm is deceitful and beauty is passing, but a woman who fears the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her all the fruit of her hands and let her own works praise her in the gates." You know, this world puts so much importance on one's outward appearance that even when some people are seeking a spouse or thinking about who their spouse might be, they might have a list of conditions that need to be met, such as beauty or looks or even somebody's height. But what the Lord puts a strong emphasis on in this passage is a woman who fears the Lord. 1 Peter chapter 3 says, "Do not let your adornment be merely outward, arranging the hair, wearing gold, or putting on fine apparel. Rather, let it be the hidden person of the heart, with the incorruptible beauty of a gentle and quiet spirit, which is very precious in the sight of God." This virtuous woman, more than anything, fears God, but you can see that all of her duties that kind of spanned over her lifetime all really center around her family and her home. When her kids were little, she was taking care of her family, feeding them, making their clothes. And as they got older, she was starting a business out of her home and even investing in real estate. So as we celebrate Mother's Day this year, are you the mother of young children? Are you feeling sleep deprived or feeling like your work is never completely finished? Feeling like as you want to be honored on Mother's Day, that you're feeling pulled between your mother and your mother-in-law and still needing to change dirty diapers and clean up after your kids? The Lord will help you. Isaiah says, "Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand." This Mother's Day, are you grieving the loss of a child, grandchild, or mother yourself? God will comfort you. Job 5:11 says, "He sets on high those who are lowly, and those who mourn are lifted to safety." Are you suffering from loneliness this Mother's Day? The Word of God says, be strong and of good courage. Do not fear nor be afraid of them. For the Lord your God, He is the one who goes with you. He will not leave you nor forsake you. Hopefully you are looking forward to a wonderful celebration of you tomorrow. Or maybe you are looking forward to honoring your mother, mother-in-law, grandmothers, or being honored yourselves tomorrow. Psalm 20 verse 4 says, may He grant you according to your heart's desire and fulfill all your purpose. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, I just lift up every mother who's celebrating this year, Lord God. I just pray that you bless these moms, that as they are busy going about their lives, Lord God, that you just fill them with your love and comfort and peace and strength and all the good things you give us all the time, Lord God. You are so worthy to be praised for the role that you've given mothers. So I pray blessings over all of these families that are represented here. And I pray that each person is richly blessed. Lord God, I also ask you to comfort for those who are struggling this holiday. Lord God, that you comfort them with a peace that cannot be comprehended by this world. If they're struggling right now, I pray that they feel that relief right now in Jesus' name. I thank you, Lord, that no matter what we're going through, that you are working behind the scenes to work it out for our good. And we thank you that you do that in our lives over and over again. And we pray today in Jesus' name, amen. I want to wish all of you moms who are watching a happy, happy Mother's Day. I love and appreciate you all so much, and thank you for tuning into this video. If you guys have not subscribed and feel led to do so, that would be so awesome. And give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. And as always, feel free to leave any questions, comments, or concerns below. I will continue to pray for you this week, and take care. God bless you.